Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Aggies look like a team you'd expect to be a number one team in the country. Very good at every position, but it's still early in the season. Doesn't mean they're a finished product at this point. Got to get an impressive win to maintain that top spot. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Texas A&M's really excited to watch this guy grow with this defense. That was his first tackle, but I guarantee you, he's got hundreds more coming. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. He's on the run, decides to slide. Patrick picks up about 7 yards on the scramble.
7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He has some room. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
Side doesn't get much. Good tackle.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Mike 50. Check.
They go to the ground game. He tackles him for a loss. Fans are showing you why teams hate to come here, folks. Love gets another handoff. Tackled outside after a nice pickup.
Normally you look for the pass in those kinds of situations, but a very alert play stopped that run short of the sticks.
Martindale is back awaiting the punt. Martindale takes it to 21. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Martindale's the guy everyone has their eyes on right now, Kirk, and he comes with a lot of expectations. Time will only tell if he's the new hope or if he's all hype. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. That's a great tackle at the 39-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
Second and four coming up here. Ball on their own 39. Quick out to his receiver. He's taken down around the 49-yard line. Change of quarterback, Kirby.
Got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy.
First and 10.
Ball on their own 49.
He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Third and two. Ball on the 43. Fumble. Picked up by the defense. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So they'll go up to the booth to take a few more looks to see whether or not the ball was fumbled before the ball carrier was down. So the question on this one is whether or not the ball carrier's knee hit the ground before the fumble popped loose.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
From the 30-yard line, first down. He's at the 20. He's tackled at the 10.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision. By the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
And he adds the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Time to check in and Rustin. This one was tight. The Bulldogs grabbed the win by 5.
All right, Reese, back to our game. Vincent has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Texas A&M's got a great defensive game plan, and it's working right now.
Well, even from up here, Brad, you can see their defensive speed, and they're just playing with kind of an aggressive attitude. They're going to have to maintain that to slow down this offense.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play.
Around the 44-yard line. So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
From their own 44-yard line, first down. He's on the run. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance.
Down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. You expect this every time you're here, and you're never disappointed. This crowd is amazing. he's tackled right around the 46-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. So the Aggies with a touchdown lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Hey, Mike's 50, Mike's 50.
Right here, right here.
Ready?
Nice run up the middle.
That's good for a game. Makes it second and six.
Right. Second down and six. Ball on the 42.
Hey, we got Mike 50. Ready?
Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
That makes it third and seven.
He scrambled, brought down around the 42-yard line. Riley to punt. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Texas A&M up 7 points. And he's taken down at the 30.
That'll make it second and inches.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Here's the throw to the fullback, and they make the stop at the 33. Complete for 3 yards, and that's good for a first down.
Nice throw and catch there to get past the sticks.
Up the middle for a nice gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
The quarterback held on to it and turned it into a first down. That's very frustrating for this defense.
Makes it first and 10.
The Red Raiders lost a player earlier, and Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Made at the 48.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Hey, Mike 50, Mike 50.
He might have a chance. And now the ball is loose. Defense says they've got it, and they do.
I tell you, when the option works, it can be beautiful to watch. But when it doesn't, it can go horribly wrong. Not a good result for the offense.
So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reverse the call on the field. From the 35-yard line, it's first down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, 5 wide receivers.
And he is drilled
at the 32.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Texas A&M is up a score. Looks to the back and can't connect. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. Almost intercepted there. So fourth down coming up.
And give credit to the defense there. They played very disciplined and were able to break up the pass.
Quick to an open man, he dropped it. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Zips it to the back. And down he goes
at about the 39-yard line.
The defense provided good pressure on the play, but they just weren't able to get to the quarterback that time.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. He's out of bounds at the 49.
You like the faith he has in his receiver to just put the ball up and let him go get it.
From the 49-yard line, first down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
To that quickly. They'll bring him down
at about the 29-yard line.
Check, check, 98 Weasel! 98 Weasel!
Got his back, but he can't hang on. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. At the 20, makes it to the 17.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Play, and that is first and goal.
That's good for a game of 11 yards.
Check, check, box two, box two. Kill, kill,
kill.
Ready, flag and five, flag and five.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete.
Jones continued to receive the play.
That brings it. This is the 10th play of this drive. The kick is up, and he got it. So at the end of the half, Texas A&M leads it 7-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. People say college football is evolving. It's completely an offensive game. Boy, not this one. This one has that old school, hard-nosed, tough feel to it.
Yeah, and it's good. It's kind of refreshing. And I know the younger guys, you like all the points all the time, but it's fun to watch these kind of games because you see two defenses flying around. It looks like there's 12 or 13 guys on that side of the football making big plays, making big hits, holding the offenses down. In a world where we have all the fast-paced, up-tempo, scoring points galore, it's good to see some defenses bow their necks and play some good, pretty good ball.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Tackle made at the 29. They're ready to begin another drive. Texas A&M is up by four. He's to the 40. Makes it out to about the 43. From their own 43-yard line, first down. He's on the run. Decides to slide.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. From the 25-yard line, it's second down. He's into the open field. Makes it to the 11. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 5. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Texas A&M is up 4. And he tackles him hard at the 3.
Gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
And this is the 8th play of the drive.
He can't hang. He's not going to get me. Mike's 50.
Touchdown, Aggies. And he tacks on the extra point. So an 8-play, 71-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. From their own 23-yard line, second down.
Ready,
gains his way to the 33-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
It's arguably the loudest crowd in the nation, and they are turning it up a notch. Nice run to the outside.
That's a gain of 4 on play. First down.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down.
Here we go, here we go. Let's go!
He's wrapped up for the sack. And for Garrett, that was his second sack of the game.
You know, for the rest of the game now, he's going to be looking for this guy every time he drops back to pass. Let's see if that throws off his timing.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation.
Watch the run, watch the run.
They'll run it. He's tackled
right around the 44-yard line.
Really one of the very tough places to play in college football, and it's no different. Got some open field. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 49-yard line, first down. They'll go ground. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
That'll make it 7-7.
This is the 8th play of this drive.
That's right, baby. They don't want it.
He's brought down in the open field. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Taken down in the backfield.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
This turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. Texas A&M's in front by 11. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. At the 32-yard line.
That'll bring up 34.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Always a noisy place to play and tough on the offense. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
36, 36.
And a quick throw. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. Brought down at about the 41.
Number 58 on the tackle, 41 yards.
to about the 44-yard line.
You know, the defense here had a chance to get a stop, and they gave up another first down to this offense. Again, when they get this offense into third down, it's about really stepping up and somebody making a play. That time, they were unable to do that.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. And he's taken down at the 46. Texas Tech just took their first time out. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line. Short gain. That'll move the chains.
This defense should know what's coming at this point, but this rushing attack is a tough one to stop.
Gets a carry right side. He takes it right side for a good gain. Harris gets 6 yards on the play. The Red Raiders using their third and last timeout. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it third and one.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Tackle made right around the 12-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. There he goes. Big play, and it's first and goal. Tenth play of the drive. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. All but wrapped up. So the Aggies come out on top, 14-3. As we finish up the broadcast, what do you have to say about how this game turned out, Kirk?
Well, no doubt about it, this is a pretty big mismatch. Texas Tech did a nice job of hanging in there against a far superior team, but in the end, they just didn't have enough to get it done. They played well, though. Nice job, guys.
Brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.